Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Chicago Cubs franchise series here in MLB 14, the show on the PS4. Now the Cubs are closing in on a potential playoff spot, and they could win the NL Central, but they've got a huge series with Cincinnati. They won the first game, and now they are looking at a game and a half lead over the Reds right now, 3 over the Cardinals, as we continue this series against Cincinnati, this huge series. Like I said, they got game one. You can see that in the last episode, but now we can't let down. We got to win this series and see where we stand afterwards. So teams getting ready here at Wrigley Field. You see Joey Votto talking it over with, Emilio Bonifacio there? Looks like him. The Reds know that this is huge for them as well, so we're going to have a lovely evening at Wrigley Field. This is going to be fun for Cubs fans and, well, the Reds fans that made the trip as well. So we send Jeff Samardzija to the mound. He's got 11 wins. Let's see if he can get number 12 tonight. This pitch, the splitter, strike 3 swinging. Joey Votto right there. And Samardzija is through the first inning. We go to the bottom of the first. 3-2 count to Javier Baez, and he lines that down the line and left. It gets past the left fielder. Runner coming around third to try to score, and he will. There's the first run of the game as the Cubs are now up 1-0. Rookie Javier Baez coming through yet again. What a great rookie campaign he's had, and he is all over that pitch. Third baseman has no chance to get that, and neither does the left fielder, so it goes all the way to the fence. 1-0, runner at second base. That's not getting much better for Homer Bailey. That is a base hit to left. Runners will be at the corners now. Homer Bailey not missing many bats at this point in the first inning. The Cubs right on with their swings. As a matter of fact, nobody out. And Rizzo at the plate. We know what he's been doing lately. He dribbles that one through. Could not make the play at first base there, Votto. And it is going to be a run, and runners still at the corners, still nobody out, and we've got a trip to the mound already to settle. Homer Bailey down 2-0 when Jorge Soler hits this one to center. It will be an out, but it should also be a sacrifice fly. That's cut off, and it's 3-0 Cubs. Couldn't have asked for much better of a start to this game if you are the Cubs. 3-0 now, just one out in the first. They're not done, are they? Runner taking off. Ruggiano, base hit to left. Runner will not hesitate. He's going to third. You've got first and third with still just one out as Ruggiano comes through with a hit. Now a 1-2 pitch. That is going to be low. Oh, he wanted strike 3, but it is low in the zone. Now 2-2, and that's going to cost him because Wellington Castillo comes up with a base hit. And it is now 4-0. Good patience shown by the Cubs hitters right there. If there is any good news at all for the Cincinnati Reds and Homer Bailey, it's that the Cubs stopped scoring runs right there at 4. Now Samardzija getting some defense there. Routine play. Backhand and throw to first. Baez gets the third out of the inning. And here we go to the second inning. Will it be as rough for the Reds as it was in the first? Well, there's a run right there, home. It's now 5-0 as Starlin Castro comes through with a hit. And the Cubs fans are loving this so far. We go now to the top of the fourth, and Samardzija is facing Jay Bruce. This ball is deep, and it is gone. Solo home run, and it is number 201 on his career. So he just reached that 200 home run milestone. Samardzija gives up number 201 right here. You see a leap, but that's over the basket there and into the seats, so he's not bringing that back. Now 5-1 as we go to the bottom of the fourth. That's okay because they're going to get it right back. Emilio Bonifacio goes opposite field and takes it into the bleachers. Solo home run of his own, and it's now 6-1. Let's watch the replay here as he gets enough power to the opposite field gap to take it over the fence. And the Cubs get that run right back and maintain the 5-run lead. So that is going to be it for Homer Bailey. He surrenders the ball and will head to the showers early. So as Bailey departs, Javier Baez will face a different pitcher, but same result. This is crushed to left center field and gone. Way out of here. Javier Baez hits one out of Wrigley. That's back-to-back shots, and it's now 7-1. Cubs flexing their muscles, showing some power in this inning as they hit back-to-back solo home runs. Doesn't matter who's pitching right now. The bats are hot. Samardzija gets a pop-up in foul territory behind third base, and that's caught as no Steve Bartman there to interfere. And it is a 7-1 lead through the seventh inning, or at least the top of the seventh. We go to the ninth. Now it's 9-1, and obviously not a save opportunity. I believe that's Pedro Strop in, and he is going to lock this thing down. The Cubs win game two, going away 9-1, so they're guaranteed to win this series. And that's a good feeling right there, as they're not going to lose their share of first place during this series. Your player of the game, Starlin Castro, he did go deep, but he also had four hits and five at-bats and three RBI on the night. So Starlin Castro, Javier Baez, all these guys pitching in, Bonifacio as well. So they win the first two games of the Cincinnati series. That now puts them 2.5 games up. As you see, the Cardinals just 3 games behind now. They've won 4 in a row. They're kind of hot. They might pass up the Reds. So we've got Hellickson versus Johnny Cueto in the last game of the series. We win that as well, and we sweep them. We swept Cincinnati out of town. That might put the Cardinals in second place. We'll have to check here. Yes, indeed. Cardinals by a half game are in second place. Now, the Cardinals and the Reds, if they do not end up catching the Cubs, are in a battle for the wild card spot. We'll look at that in a little while. Next up at Wrigley Field, a 4-game set against the Dodgers. We win 2 of the first 3 games in this series. And now we've got Samardzija going against Clayton Kershaw. We have to play this matchup. A pitcher's duel deluxe at Wrigley Field. Let's get to this day game. And this is going to be awesome. Can we take out Clayton Kershaw? Can we scratch enough runs to get by them and get the win? So let's see here. This is first inning action. Samardzija gets off the mound, covers first base, and they are out of the inning. It's a 1-2-3 effort. So now it's Clayton Kershaw's turn. We all know what he's done in real life. Nothing short of absolutely amazing. He's pretty much Superman out of the mound, except in the playoffs. So that's a different story, right? But here he goes against the Cubs lineup, and whoa! Castro! He's going deep again. Solo homer, so they do get a run off of Kershaw early as Castro is able to connect. He's had a hot bat. As we saw, he was the player of the game the last game we spotlighted. And now he goes 401 feet to center field or left center and takes Kershaw out of the ballpark. Well, so a rude welcoming to Wrigley Field there. That's all they're going to get, though, in the second inning. That's a little dribbler in front of the mound. Samardzija gets out and throws him out. He's through the second inning without allowing a hit or base runner. Nice start for him, as so far he's out pitching Kershaw. Well, of course, he's only made one mistake. Here's one hit fairly deep. That's Mike Olt going to center field, but nope, that's going to be caught at the warning track, and Kershaw gets through his part of the second. Okay, now with the home run aside, we're settling in for a pitcher's duel just like we thought we'd see. Here is Jeff Samardzija's turn in the third inning. This is against Kershaw. Kershaw, funny enough, is the closest one to getting a hit in the 3 innings of work so far, but no, that's a nice play by Baez, and he is out. Dodgers still looking for their first hit. Let's go to the bottom of the third. This is Bonifacio. Nope, right back at Kershaw. Nothing doing there. Cubs bats are quiet this inning. Top of the fourth. Pitcher's duel continues. It's a 3-1 count, and Adrian Gonzalez shows a good eye right there, and that is going to be the first base runner, although they have not gotten a hit. They do have a runner on, so 1-2 count to Puig, and he strikes him out. Samardzija gets through the inning. Still no hits allowed. No hit alert, although it's early. He's through four. We go to the bottom of the fourth inning, and Javier Baez, it's deep and gone. Again, a solo homer off of Clayton Kershaw. It's now 2-0 Cubs. They've been able to connect on a couple pitches. Kershaw, you know, he's smart enough to not serve him up with runners on base, although there haven't really been too many base runners. Just a couple solo home runs to make it a 2-0 Cubs lead. But how about Castro and Baez, the middle of the infield, doing it with the bats here late in the season? We go to the top of the fifth, still looking for a hit. This is a diving effort, but won't come up with it. There it is. The Dodgers get their first hit. Runner was on base with a dropped third strike that, the catcher, a.k.a. me, threw to the wrong base. So that's second and third. This is going to be a ground ball out, but it will bring the first run home for the Dodgers, making it a 2-1 ball game. So the Dodgers able to squeeze out a run with only one hit there. This is Kershaw at the plate again. And runner avoids the tag, but the throw over to first gets him. And Jeff Samardzija gets out of the inning with just the one run scored. We have a 2-1 ball game roughly halfway through. So we go to the top of the sixth. Then Puig is up, and Puig is striking out again. He's got Puig's number so far. And Samardzija is cruising. Bottom of the sixth inning. This is Baez again. This one's down the left field line, and it's down for a hit. He is playing awesome down the stretch here for the Cubs. Big-time contributor with the bat. And we're loving what we're seeing here. So a 3-2 count. Nobody out. This is going to be a walk to Castro. Kershaw cannot get that pitch. Yeah, you can tell he wanted it. He doesn't get it. And that's going to be the end of the day for Kershaw. Mattingly's going to come get him now. And you know he can't be happy about the early exit here. Just a 2-1 game. But they sense that it could be getting away. Here is Rizzo, and what a play by Adrian Gonzalez. He definitely saves a run with that snag. My goodness, what a play and what reaction over at first base. So with one out and runners at second and third, the contact play is on. Oh, they would have had him at home, but that's a bad throw. Baez scores, and it makes it 3-1. They had the contact play on, and like I said, they would have had him with a good throw, but that's not the case. Here's a base hit up the middle, looking to make this 4-1. And there's another run. So the Cubs getting to the Dodgers bullpen now as these innings go by. And they take a 4-1 lead to the eighth, but the bases are loaded. Pedro Stropin now in relief. A couple of those runners got on Samardzija before he was lifted. And now a sacrifice fly is going to make it 4-2. As you have a runner moving up to third as well. So Strope trying to get out of here. 3-2 count, two outs. This will be a broken bat, and oh, he missed the ball. I think he was distracted by the bat barrel flying out there into the infield, and he overran the ball. It's now 4-3. The Dodgers make it a one-run game. Bottom of the eighth, Nate Scherholz pinch hitting, and he comes through with a hit. Runner coming around third to score, and he's safe. Insurance run. Nice job by Scherholz hitting in the pitcher's spot and delivering an insurance run. So on comes Ryan Madsen, 47 saves. He's up there with the leaders, just a few off the pace, and looking to get number 48. He gets it right there. Matt Kemp swinging, and Samardzija gets another win. We've seen two in this episode, and that should be good for 13 wins on the season. Madsen gets save number 48, and guess what? It was his 100th of his major league career. Javier Baez is your player of the game. First Castro, now Baez. Both these guys making huge contributions, not only with their gloves in the middle of the diamond, but with their bats especially. So we win 3 of 4 against the Dodgers. Look at this. Just 3 losses all month. What a great time for the Cubs as they are now surging. But the St. Louis Cardinals are now, well, they're tied for second place there with the Reds. Both 4 games back. This is feeling good. 4-game lead for us in the division with 6 to play. You look at the wild card, and as I said, the Reds and Cardinals are fighting for that second wild card spot. So don't tell me this isn't a huge series for the Cardinals coming up here at Wrigley Field. It'll be the last 3 games at home before we go on the road to Milwaukee to end it out. Let's see if the Cubs can do it. We'll see you next time.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.